to get in here.
Sit out, will you? Looking out the window is not going to make the pole get here any faster.
It's almost 5, and express mail guaranteed delivered before 5.
Express mail? Why don't you use us?
Us? We suck.
I can't believe Carrie went for it. She doesn't seem like the pleasing type.
She didn't want to do it at first, but after she tried it for a couple of weeks, she really loves it. She says it gets her in touch with her inner whore. It's
nice. The rich get richer.
This thing to come quick. You know, I am ready for my first dance. You know what I'm saying? I'm ready.
Uh-huh.
Check this out. Look what she made for me. Coupons.
Here for one free pole dance from Misty Heffernan. Don't you guys have an aunt named Misty Heffernan?
Yeah, she just said hip surgery.
Guess who's here? The pole fairy.
Someone just bought himself a new nickname.
Come on, guys, give me a hand.
Hey, Arthur, I'm gonna make a sandwich. You want one?
Nope.
You sure?
A man who turns his own daughter into an exotic dancer does not deserve to eat.
They've got fresh corned beef.
No! Oh, there it goes. A 10-foot arrow through my heart.
What are you even talking about?
Damn it, Matt, don't you understand? When a child doesn't get enough love and affection from her own father, she seeks it from strange men. That's why Carrie's doing this. Because I spent her childhood chasing after the almighty dollar.
Yeah, how'd that work out for you?
Look, Arthur, you're getting worked up over nothing, okay? She's just gonna dance for Doug.
Oh, sure. That's how it starts. And it's peep shows, strip joints, and before long she's at the Port Authority in hot pants, beckoning drunken Marines into the back of an abandoned bus.
What's that? Pumpernickel? Cut me off half. Yeah?
Misty is ready. Don't forget the coupon.
Misty?
Get in the bathroom. Turn on the music and settle in, big boy.
The Pelican Brief by John Grisham.
Sitting.